Okay, this is Unlock Circuits 18EC42 module 4, lecture 4. We are studying about the op amp with negative feedback. And today we'll take up summing, scaling, and averaging amplifier. Till now we studied the basics, the non-inverting amplifier, the inverting amplifier, and the DC and AC amplifiers. So now we'll be checking the summing, scaling, and averaging amplifiers. So here in the summing, scaling, and averaging amplifiers, there'll be different categories. One is inverting and another is non-inverting configuration. And the third is difference amplifier, which is the combination of difference or differential amplifier, which is the combination of inverting as well as non-inverting. So the figure for the summing circuit and averaging and all that, you know, all the three cases, summing, scaling, and averaging is just the same, only that the values are going to change. So now you can see that you have three inputs. You have here three inputs, VA, VB, VC, and connected with that you have three resistors, RA, RB, RC. You are joining all these resistors and giving it to the inverting terminal over here, because we are talking about inverting configuration. And also we have a feedback resistor, which is RF. The positive point is grounded through a resistor. This is not for any other purpose except to see that the IB1 is kept as low as possible. Okay, that is all. Otherwise, there is not much job associated with this. So it doesn't have much significance there. Then we have the load resistance, which is the load resistance output, whatever input resistance of the, next circuit, which might be there over here. That is what the load means. Input impedance or input resistance of the circuit, which might be connected to the output of this op amp. Okay. So now having this VA, VB, VC, then because this is grounded through this, this is at the, zero voltage. Therefore, we call this as virtual ground. Because this is grounded, we call this as virtual ground. And this will also be at zero potential. Current entering through this is also zero. So that's why, generally what we will write is all the three currents, IA, IB, IC, joined together and come over here. And that will be equal to the currents IF and IB. However, IB will consider zero because current cannot enter the op amp. So effectively, it is just IA plus IB plus IC will be equal to the IF only. IA plus IB plus IC is equal to IF. But what is written in the book is IB plus IF. IB is effectively zero only, because the input impedance of the op amp is infinite. Input impedance of the op amp is infinite. So once we write that, then we can write the current value IA will be VA minus, this is zero potential, by RA. VA minus zero by RA, or effectively VA by RA is IA, VB by RB is IB, VC by RC is IC, because the V2 value is zero because of the reason that it is considered to be at virtual ground when the what you call plus is V1 is grounded through whatever resistor is there over here. That does not matter. Okay, so V2 will be virtual ground, therefore VA by RA plus VB by RB plus VC by RBC is equal to the value of zero minus V0 by RF. This is zero minus V0 by RF. So it is effectively minus V0 by RF is equal to VA by RA plus VA by RB plus VA by RC. So if you just cross multiply, then we'll get V0 is equal to minus RF by RA into VA plus RF by RB into VB plus RF by RC into VC. So this is the equation which we'll get at the output, because of the reason that here the currents is VA by RA plus VB by RB plus VC by RC is equal to minus V0 by RF. RF you take it on the other side, minus also you take on the other side, then you are going to get this equation. So this equation will give us the overall thing. The same thing is written over here, VA by RA, VB by RB, VC by RC is equal to minus V0 by RF. and rearranging that, you are going to get this value. So now, if the value of RA, RB, and RC are same, if RA and RB and RC are same, then we'll get the value equal to RF. You can just take it out common. Okay, so this RA, RB, RC is equal to R. If you put, then RF by R, you can take out common and you'll get VA plus VB plus VC. Further to that, if RF is equal to R, that means if RA is equal to RB is equal to RC is equal to RF, if you have, then we will get V0 is equal to minus VA plus VB plus VC. Sum of all the input voltages with the inversion will give us the output voltage, which is V0. Then you can also use it for scaling or weighting purpose by taking proper ratio. That means might be that I want minus of VA plus 2VB plus 3VC. Then at that time, what I need to do is RF by RA, I make it equal to 1. RF by RB, you make it 2. RF by RC, you make it 3. Then I'll get VA plus 3VB plus 2VB plus 3VC with a minus sign. So by choosing proper ratios of RF by RA, RF by RB, RF by RC, you can do scaling and weighting of the inputs, and the scaled and weighted value of the inputs will become the output. Also, we can use the same circuit for averaging purpose by using RF by R is equal to 1 by N, where N is the number of the inputs. In our case, the number of inputs is 1 by number of inputs is 3. Here we have taken, so therefore, when 3 inputs are there, if I put 1 by 3 as each one of this value which is written here, RF by RA, RF by RB, and RF by RC as 1 by 3, then the whole thing will be V0 is equal to minus VA plus VB plus VC divided by 3. And that will become the averaging, but inverting value. Okay, we are talking about inverting. So V0 is equal to minus VA plus VB plus VC by 3. So thus, we will get in a single circuit by just varying the values of the resistors, either the summing amplifier or weighted amplifier or averaging amplifier, weighted or scaled both are same, or the averaging amplifier. Okay, so now let us take a numerical here. In the circuit of the figure, we have VA equal to 1, VB equal to 2, VC equal to 3, all the resistors, RA, RB, RC is 3 kilo ohms, RF is 1 kilo ohm, ROM, which does not have any significance as far as the calculation of the output is concerned, he has given it, so it is a waste for us, and supply voltage is plus or minus 15 volts. Assuming that the op amp is initially null, determine the output voltage V0. So we need to find out the V0 value. So we are given 1, 2, and 3 with all the values, so it will be just RF by R, RF by R equal to somehow. So now, if once these things are given and the value of RA, RB, and RC is same, and then you have RF, so you need to just use the formula which is there here. Right, it is this formula which you are using, because RA, RB, and RC is equal to R, but RF is different. So RF is the value which is given to us. We can just check what is the value given. 1, and the RA, RB, RC is equal to 3. So we'll get 1 by 3 over here. We'll get 1 by 3 over here. Here 1 plus 2 plus 3, whatever we have, right? The value is given 1 plus 2 plus 3, and we will get there as minus 2 volts, right? 1 by 3 with a minus value, and this 10 to the power of 3 is because it is kilo. 1 plus 2 plus 3 is VA plus VB plus VC. This is equal to minus 2 volts. So this is just an averaging amplifier which we have over here, right? So now going to the non-inverting configuration. Right? So till now we considered the inverting configuration. Now we'll go for the non-inverting configuration. the non-inverting configuration looks something like this, right? Where to the plus input, we are connecting VA, VB, and VC through a resistance R, which is common. Then we have R1 and RF4 here, right? So we need to find the voltage at this point by superposition. Superposition means only VA is present, VB and VC are not present. What is the value of the V1? What is the value of the V1 when VA, VB, and VC are given over here? When VA is there, VB and VC are not there, then what is the value of V1? When VB is there and VA and VC are not there, what is the value of V1? When VA and VB are connected to ground and only VC is there, what is the value here? And sum them up. That is what is superposition. So if two of them are connected to ground, say VA is there and VB and VC are connected to ground, so these two will come in parallel and we'll have R/2. So V1 will be the voltage across R/2 there. So we'll have R and R/2. We'll have R and then R/2 connected to ground. So the current flowing through that will be VA divided by R plus R/2. VA divided by R plus R/2. Multiplied by the value R/2 will give us the value of V1. So thus, we'll get this here. For just VA input and VB and VC equal to 0, we are going to get R/2 divided by R plus R/2 into VA. Current will be this, VA divided by R plus R/2, because to VB and VC we are connecting 0, that is ground, and that will give us the equivalent resistance there as R in parallel with R, that is R/2. So total resistance will be R and R/2, and that's why VA by R plus R/2 will be the current, multiplied by the R/2 will give us the voltage at V1 only for VA, similarly for VB, similarly for VC. So you can see here R/2, R plus R/2. So this is 3R/2, this is 3R/2, all this. So therefore, you'll get VA by 3, VB by 3, VC by 3 as the value of V1. So V1 is just the averaged value of the inputs we are going to get. V1 will be the average value here. Now once V1 is found, rest of the thing is just a non-inverting amplifier with a gain of 1 plus RF by R1. 1 plus RF by R1. Is the gain which we have already seen for the non-inverting amplifier. So under that condition, 1 plus RF by R1 into VA plus VB plus VC by 3 is what we are going to get over here. Right? We are going to get here that value. So same thing is being written over here. VA V0 is equal to 1 plus RF by R1 into V1, because this is a non-inverting amplifier, and hence we are going to get this value over here, and V1 is nothing but VA plus VB plus VC by 3. So again, averaging amplifier is the only way is to make the RF value equal to 0. If you make the value of RF equal to 0 or R1 equal to infinity or both of them, then you are just going to get a buffer. You are going to get a voltage follower or a buffer. If this is shorted, RF is shorted, and R1 is opened, then you are going to get a buffer or a voltage follower. That means whatever the output will be equal to input, at that time it is going to become an averaging amplifier. But now we will have the average without the inversion. Earlier case we had the average with inversion, now we have average without the inversion. Summing if we want, then we want V0 equal to VA plus VB plus VC, but we have the formula over here. So that's why this quantity should be equal to 3. This value should be equal to 3. 3 and 3 will cancel and we'll get the sum of that. So that this is 3, we should choose the value of RF to be twice of R1. If RF is chosen twice of R1, this will become 3. 3 cancels and we will get V0 equal to VA plus VB plus VC. And that is what we have here. RF is equal 1 plus RF by R1 equal to 3. That will be RF by R1 is equal to 2. That is RF equal to 2 R1 will give us the value of V0 equal to VA plus VB plus VC, which I think might be you might have done in the lab also. I don't know. Okay. So let us take an example over here of what you call the inverting amplifier circuit. And then here he has given you the value of the supply voltage. VA, VB is minus 3, VC is plus 4, R equal to R1 equal to 1 kilo ohm, RF equal to 2 kilo ohm. So we can just use that, values R equal to R1 is written here. So naturally the formula V1 is the average value, which is 2 here plus 2 minus 3 plus 4 by 3. That is equal to 1 volt. And the once V1 is found, then V0 is equal to 1 plus RF by R1 into V1. RF is 2 kilo ohm, R1 is 1 kilo ohm. So therefore, we'll get this as 3. 3 into 1 will give me the value of 3 volts, which is the sum of the 3 inputs itself. Then we come to the differential configuration. Okay, the differential configuration, we can come to that. And this is as a subtractor you can use, or otherwise what you can use, we'll just see how that is. I think how much 6 minutes is there. I think we'll take this up in the next session. So if you have any doubts, you can ask. Otherwise you can join this, what you call next session. And we will do the differential configuration in the next session.